let's explore our solar system with this Learning Resources Solar System Puzzle Globe toy. The first piece goes up here on the top. This is the Sun. The Sun is a star that's very close to us, which is why it looks so bright. All the stars you see at night are other suns that are really far away. All the planets move around the Sun. That's called an orbit. Earth orbits the Sun once every year. The closest planet to the Sun is Mercury. And look, this puzzle piece matches. Mercury is the smallest planet in the solar system. The next planet is Venus. This puzzle piece has a square peg. So it goes here. Venus is the second planet from the Sun, and it's very hot there since all the clouds trap the heat from the Sun. The next planet looks familiar. This is Earth, and it's where we all live. It goes right here. Earth is the only place that we know life exists. It's always spinning, which means that half of it is always facing the Sun at any one time. That's how we get night and day. When it's night, it means that where you live is pointing away from the Sun. And during the day, we are facing the Sun. Next is this red planet. It's Mars, and it goes right here on the puzzle. Mars is red because of a mineral on its surface called iron oxide. That makes it look red when you see it through a telescope from Earth. The clouds on Mars are made of ice, and it never rains there. Next up is Jupiter, the biggest planet in our solar system. The puzzle peg goes right here. Jupiter is made of gas, and there are always storms raging. One storm, the Big Red Spot, has been going on for hundreds of years. Jupiter is not a good place for a holiday. Saturn is next. The star-shaped puzzle peg fits right here. Saturn is called the jewel of the solar system. It has amazing rings around it, and the planet is made of helium gas, which is super light. It's like a balloon. This blue planet is next. It's Uranus. The puzzle peg matches right here. Uranus is really far from the Sun, so it's super cold and has lots of ice. Uranus was the first planet discovered with a telescope. The next planet is also super cold and icy. This is Neptune. The puzzle peg matches here. It's the last planet in our solar system, and the furthest from the Sun. It looks blue because there's lots of gas called methane. Now we've added all the planets. Let's see if you remember their names. What's this huge yellow thing on top? That's right, it's not a planet, it's the Sun. All the planets orbit the Sun, remember? Do you remember this grey one? Yes, it's Mercury. Next is this orange planet. It's Venus, that's right. I'm sure you remember this next blue and green planet. Yes, it's Earth. That's where we live. How about the red planet? That's right, it's Mars. Do you remember this one? It's the biggest planet. Jupiter, that's right. How about this planet with the pretty rings? This is Saturn. Good job. What is this next planet called? Yes, it's Uranus. And the final planet? That's right, it's Neptune. Well done. And look, it's a little red rocket and an astronaut. We can add them down here. Now, let's look at these groups of stars called constellations. This one is called the Little Dipper. It looks like an upside-down pot with a handle. This next one is called the Big Dipper. It also looks like a pot, but this one is a bit bigger. And the last one is called Cassiopeia. It sort of looks like the letter W. Humans have been exploring the solar system with space rockets like this space shuttle that used a massive tank of gas to reach space and then was able to orbit the Earth. And today we even have a space station that's always traveling high above the Earth in space. This is the International Space Station, or the ISS for short. It was built by 15 countries and 5 space agencies, and has always had someone on board ever since the year 2000. It's the largest spaceship ever built, and it orbits the Earth nearly 16 times a day. That means it sees 16 sunrises and sunsets every day. It moves at 28,000 kilometers an hour. That's 90 times faster than a Formula One race car. It gets power from these huge solar panel arrays that are each larger than the wingspan of a passenger plane, and in total it has over 262,000 solar cells. The ISS is about the size of a football field, and it's a really great place to do science experiments that can't be done on Earth, since the gravity is much less on the ISS. You can even see it fly over sometimes at sunrise or sunset. It does travel around the Earth every 90 minutes, so you might get lucky and catch a glimpse. Thanks for exploring the solar system with me.